Hi, hello. Good wishes to everyone. See, we are back to our class. So now we are going to see about what direct speech and indirect speech. What direct speech and indirect speech? See, already in English we has, that is English has, that is two speeches. Right? Is two speeches. Right? What are they? See, direct speech and indirect speech. Yes, already I told you that English has two voices. That is active voice and passive voice. See now, as well as see that speeches, that is English has two speeches, that is direct speech and indirect speech. Yes, see, first what is direct speech, right? Direct speech. So direct, see, by seeing the word itself you can understood that directly, which is said directly. Yes, direct information, that is direct process. Yes, so direct dealing, right? So direct speech, so the speech is said in direct manner. Yes, it is not an indirect, is direct process, right? See the definition. See, words of the speaker, that is the actual words of the speaker, and tense of the verb, that is action, right, are the same as the speaker says. So everything will be what the speaker says. Yes, in the sentence, see, all things will be, that is those things will be what the speaker says. Yes, it will presented in what the speaker says. Yes, see, let me recall that. See, words of the speaker and tense of the verb are the same as the speaker says, right? So everything will perform, that is everything will we can able to perform what the speaker says, right? What the speaker says. And while talking about the indirect, so actually that is opposite of direct speech. So indirect, so everything it will perform in indirect. Yes, so indirect process will be going to happen here, right? So indirect speech, see here, so opposite that. So the speaker or reported by someone else. Yes, so it will reported by, that is directly, so it is reported by someone else. Yes, that is called as, that is named as indirect. So indirectly we are getting, not from the direct person, right? So indirectly, yes, in between some mediator we will use. Yes, so indirectly we are getting information from others, right? So that is this direct speech, we are getting direct information. Here indirect speech, so we are getting indirectly we are getting the information, right? See, let us see the example. Look at the example. We are not going for the picnic. See the difference between direct speech and indirect speech. See here, we are not going for the picnic. Yes, it is enclosed in a quotation, right? Whether it may be a single quotation or double quotation. So it is enclosed in a single quotation, right? See, at last, said, who said? Rima. Yes, who said? Rima said, right? So we are not going for the picnic. Yes, we should stop, we should pass there. So we are not going for the picnic. Who said? Said Rima, right? So said Rima, right? So this is a direct speech. And while talking, that is while converting to indirect speech, right? See here, Rima said that they were not going to the picnic. So Rima said that they were not going to the picnic. See here, this is in this sentence, Rima is placed in the, that is place of the object, right? So here Rima placed in the subject, right? In the place of the subject. Yes, actually the meaning is same, that is it's similar, it is performing the similar meaning, but the way of saying, yes, the way of informing us may vary, right? See here, we are not going for the picnic. Yes, said Rima. Who said? Rima. Yes, so directly they have insisted there. So here Rima said that. So we are using what? That. Yes, here. See here, I have mentioned here. So you should keep remember, actually what you should keep in your mind means, see, direct means it should be enclosed in quotation. And indirect speech, see, that will mention by that, by using that. Yes, so that will indicate the indirect speech. Yes, so that, you should use that. Yes, in between, while starting to say the, I'll say about the speaker, right? Who said, who is going to say? Yes, you, while indicating that, you should use that. Yes, you should use that, right? So these both are the difference. That is, you should end while talking about the direct speech, you should that is indicate, that is denote everything in other enclosed by the double quotation or single quotation. Anyhow, it should be in quotation, enclosed in quotation. And we're talking about the indirect speech. We should mention, we should indicate by using that. So that in between the sentence, in between the sentence, right? See there. So we are not going for the picnic. It is enclosed in the quotation. Said Reema. Here, see here reversely. That is, Reema said that they were not going to the picnic. So Reema said that, we are using that here. So that they were not going to the picnic. So indirectly we are getting information. Yes. And while talking about that, see, look at the next example. See, Rajan said. See, I'm enclosing the main theme in the quotation, right? I'm not talking to Raman. So Rajan said, I'm not talking to Raman, right? And while talking about the indirect speech, see, I'm converting to indirect speech. So Rajan said the same thing. We are starting from that. See, the same thing only we are starting. See here, Rajan said that he was not talking to Raman. So we are using what? That. So we are using what? That to indicate the, that is to represent the indirect speech. Yes, we are going to say. Yes, we are going to apply there in indirect speech there. So for that we are using what? That. Yes, that in between the sentence. So Rajan said that he was not talking to Raman. Yes. So these are the difference between only the two difference. See, while talking about the direct speech, we should enclose in, that is enclosed in the sentence, that main theme should be enclosed in what? Quotation, right? And indirect speech, while talking about the indirect speech, we should explain, that is, we should indicate, we should represent, yes, we should describe, yes, by using that in between the sentence, while starting to say about the concept or theme or about the speaker, right? So this two things are the difference, that is, it contains two differences, right? Only this enclosed in the quotation, and this for this the indirect speech, yes, we will use that in between sentence, right? So let us recall. See, the direct speech means, see, the actual words of the speaker and tense of the verb, or as the speaker says. Yes, so whatever it may be, everything will be what the speaker says. It should be what the speaker says. And we're talking about the indirect speech. Yes, the speaker are reported by someone else. Yes, it is in indirect process. That is, indirectly we are getting information from someone. Yes, not directly from someone. Yes, so it is named as what? It will comes in the indirect speech. So direct speech is, we are getting directly information from direct person, and we are getting here indirect. The indirectly we are getting information from someone else, right? So that is named as what? Indirect speech, right? So these are all the examples. See, while converting, we should use these things. See, for direct speech, we should the theme should be enclosed in what? Quotation. And while converting to the indirect speech, we should use that, yes, in between the sentence, right? So these are the examples of direct speech and indirect speech. I hope you all understood. See, such an easy one. You just go through it and recall it. Yes, just capture it once. Yes, please don't forget these things. Yes. So thank you, students.